Hey everybody!
Hi there!
Here's our video from our trip to Europe. Recently we flew from Oregon all the way to Dublin. Our overqualified driver, Patrick Ball, picked us up in Dublin and drove us around on our time off around our concert there.
Unicorns.
Looks like it. It was really neat.
Castle Court.
I had never been able to spend that much time in Ireland before.
This is my first trip.
There's our bed and breakfast, where we got to breakfast, where we ate breakfast. Does in his spare time.
Magical land.
Everything is so green. This was our concert in a little old church.
The Carolan Festival in Nobber.
The place of his birth. Awesome performers. Man, oh man.
Smoking. She's now the chieftain's harper.
Cormac DeBar is awesome.
So beautiful.
Did our show about the legends of the harp through time.
But they also say that at night
gets me every time. And afterwards, we go to the pubs. Every night, we play music somewhere. Young kids play so good.
And then I teach my signature tune.
Droman all over the world. And the town of Nobber was O'Carolan's place of birth, the blind Irish harper from the 17th century.
Then we went to Oliver House.
where he was taken in. If you know the story, it's an incredible landmark.
That's the very car Carolan drove. I was wondering about that car. That's a very fine car.
And it was astounding. It's really beautiful.
Right there in that window is where Carolan died.
So magical, so incredible.
It's like a pilgrimage to a sacred place.
A pilgrimage, and here's where he's buried.
His music has been so important to so many people for so long.
The whole area honors him. Saw some beautiful places. Patrick knew all the beauty spots.
It's a Sligo area.
We're sorry. Excuse us.
I'll speak to them.
Right, left.
Go to the left.
All right.
Yeah, we had a couple days in Ireland. It was so beautiful, totally memorable. And then we got back on the plane and flew to Amsterdam.
Holland.
Aryeh's people are there.
A lot of family there.
And here they are. They treated us like royalty. It was so nice.
There are many, many bicycles. Man. And today we're going to celebrate my birthday.
Yes, my couple.
It's taking me somewhere. I don't know where.
Wander the streets, antique shops, wonderful street performers, beer and more beer. A lot of walking.
I'm going to Amersfoort to visit relatives and do a concert in Well, which is Belgium.
No, Well is in Holland. We're going to Belgium Sunday.
Okay.
Going to our concert in Well. It's a brand new harp store that just opened.
Here it is. In Well.
De Troubadour Harpen. And they had their grand opening.
Here's our poster. And
here's the store.
Here's the store.
Verschillende de harps.
So beautiful. It has all these harps.
Yeah, triplet harps.
Triplet harps.
And my also
personal favorite. Family. Bought this storefront. And they live here also. Have workshops and rooms for.
That's the harp I'm going to play on right there.
This one? Very nice. Play something for me.
And then we did work workshops. I did one on improvising. I love doing that. Another beautiful church, another beautiful concert. Venue.
Music Tay.
The best of like acoustic folk venues. Really special place. Making this beautiful food for us.
Bouillabaisse. That's Dirk. He's a great musician, bagpipe player.
And the concert presenter. Went into a lot of beautiful churches. I can't even remember name them all.
Friend Suzanne, who took us around, was marvelous.
Jammed at their house.
And this is Fred and Suzanne. Fantastic musicians.
Back on the bus.
This is my cousin in Utrecht.
Fresh.
He loves fresh herring.
Pickles.
No pickles. There he goes, folks. He loves the herring. That's a happy man. If you want another one, it's just throw them in.
No, I like this.
Okay.
Oh, I'm trying to.
This is what I'm doing a lot of. Following Aryeh down unknown streets. Lots of bicycles.
New friends. They Omnia. Are from Omnia.
Yeah.
This is what they do.
Steve and Jenny.
Totally wrong.
Used to come to this forest and paint a lot. And she actually painted these things.
That's exactly.
This was, this exactly was her, these views. This
yeah.
Path.
Yeah. Yeah.
This path.
Especially
looks like a painting.
In a few weeks, this will be golden.
Wow. And then that's. They made us a beautiful dinner in their home, and then of course we played music. And on we went to Denmark.
Yeah, we had a Nordic Harp Conference. And there is our friend Eric, Askud Mark, and Reineforce.
More incredible musicians.
We are in Sweden. Mm. It's his favorite snack.
And then Aryeh had arranged to buy this nickel harpa that was made for a year or something.
Months. Eric Gustafsson made this for me in Holland, Sweden, on the east coast. Excuse me, west coast.
But I'm very happy. Sweden. So this is. Are you going to be okay with me to take this instrument away from you? You're all.
Looks like you're walking in a painting.
It's incredible. That they had used as a museum, an open museum for the land and the buildings. It's incredible.
It's like a dream.
It's a fairyland. It's like a dream. This is a somebody doing a cooling for us,
which is
a herding call, and it's extremely powerful music to call the cows and the sheep, and from the pasture they could hear it for miles.
That's awesome.
It really feels like.
Eric took us to some beautiful sites, churches. And on to the Harp Conference, where we got to participate by doing some workshops and some performances.
This is near Copenhagen.
Played at the dances each night. Good sized bar right by the stage too.
I'm giving a little lecture on my how to arrange traditional music to the participants.
Really good musicians. I mean, every student was a really great musician. Anna, she rocks at everything she does.
On Swedish music to the harpers there.
These are a lot of the same tunes you teach at Lark Camp, so the Larkies and the Swedes could play these tunes together.
This is a good exercise is because it's a practice in dynamics. Teeniness to bigness to a section with building suspense. And it's easy to get right here because it falls straight down the scale for the most part. So I'll give you a demonstration of the three parts. And then we'll do them together and I'll see.
This is a cantele from Finland. Amazing musicians.
Mm-hmm.
Benjamin Bagby. We got to go to a concert of Aryeh and I, this beautiful church. They're so amazing.
This is a friend of theirs playing the harpsichord. We're the next stop, and it's in 10 minutes.
Okay.
Okay.
Cheers.
So now we're off to Retvik, Dalarna, in the heart of the folk music capital of Sweden. And meeting my friends there. These are the folks who brought me to Sweden originally, way back in 1994-95.
Yeah,
Stefan Ekedal, Jonas Kroning.
The story he tells in concerts. That's them! They're rock stars.
That's Lake Siljan.
Oh, we went to a special school for music and arts and did a little presentation.
Mm-hmm. We gave them a lecture on professional performance in the United States and told them what it was like to be a professional musician.
Those were super cool kids, college age. They all speak multiple languages. We only have one.
Fellow who's looking at us, Peter, he's an incredible guitar player, just, and he's the dean of the school.
So this is sort of an example of where, in a show, we would talk about a rock and roll background, and new music being made in Sweden.
And we did a concert for all the students.
Thank you.
Now we're taking some walks around Redvik with our friends, Stefan and Betty Ekedal. Betty Binder, excuse me.
Dinner parties, kitty cats, jam sessions.
And these are more of our friends.
Scenery. Oh, and then the folk music center.
Yep, this is
really
a folk music
impressive.
House.
Musical museum with headphones, you listen to the different instruments.
Just absolutely spectacular.
The sun came out for us most of the days after we got there. Lucky.
Where are we now?
We're in Dalhalla. This was once a quarry, and they made it into a, after they finished mining. And this is the biggest crowd and the biggest stage I've ever played in my life.
Wow.
I think 5,000 people can.
Look at that.
Yeah.
And it has a little lake right next to the stage. Look at that.
It was one of the most
exciting,
frightening, terrifying, but thrilling.
How many people?
I think there was about 4,500 people.
Wow.
And Dervish was the band and Boys of the Lock.
You were right between those guys.
I opened the show, and then I played in between them.
Oh, my goodness.
And then I played at the end with them.
All thanks to this incredible musician and friend, Jonas Holmein.
Yay. He brought you here.
That is Sigurd Sahlström, the son of Erik Sahlström. And he's a teacher of nickel harp there. It was very special for me to meet him. And I'm playing signature tune.
More good dinners and parties, man.
And that's Blåbergens Bodunar.
That's the name of the band.
That is Anders Neruda, one of the most famous musicians in all of Sweden. There is Stefan Ekedal.
We love Stefan. Good friend.
It's quite an honor to play with the composer of the tune, sitting right next to you, Anders Neruda. He's quite a guy.
And there was a big party planned.
Yeah.
Set up for the party for somebody's birthday. It was a couple of people's birthday.
It was several birthdays, and it was also an anniversary for Blåbergens Bodunar, my favorite band.
Celebration of their album.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday
for me. Happy birthday to me.
Oh! vilken icken är och styr oss omkring. Danser för dig och hoppas rätt och spring. Önskar dig av hjärta alla goda ting. Och si mig så, vad vill du med det?
And we get to do a few tunes. Aryeh played a beautiful harp tune. And then we played a couple tunes, although I didn't get any footage of that.
And the Globergen's Bordüner.
Headliners went on about 3 a.m. And everyone was still totally into partying. Oh my gosh. Just loving it. And then afterwards, we got to play with the composer of Drummond.
There he is.
Right ready. In the middle. You couldn't believe we loved the song so much and taught it to so many people all over the world in our summer camps and in concert. And such an honor, and he's such a humble guy.
There he is.
Freddie Frederickson. Oh, and then Aryeh's surprise.
My birthday present.
Hey, Dad, happy birthday.
Here's
getting
Abraham.
Up there. Hope you have a good day. Love you.
Many happy years.
My mom.
There you go.
Happy birthday to you.
Deborah Hanson Connett.
This is just small clippets. We had like 30 minutes of these greetings.
I never felt more
happy birthday, Aryeh.
Honored and
loved.
Loved.
Yay. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday.
Rest. You're held in great esteem. You're chasing every dream.
Doing Drummond.
At least we hope you're less depressed.
My cousin.
Dear cousin.
Aryeh, it's your birthday. And you're closer to Norway.
Happy birthday.
And I wanted to wish you a happy birthday. And it's time for you to come on home. You can mess around with them pissing foreigners and godless communists. Time for you to come home. Be sweet and green. Anyway, happy birthday and God bless you.
The people at the party wanted to stay and watch the whole thing too. It was so neat.
I was really overwhelmed. I still am. Now we're on our way home.
Aryeh's favorite thing is to fly.
Not. We had to fly back to Dublin.
It was a month. We were gone for a month. We couldn't possibly capture all the brilliant, magical moments. We'll remember this the rest of our life.
It was the greatest trip.
All the way back home to our beautiful farm in Oregon.
Yay.
Thanks, everybody, for going with us on this trip. Hope you enjoyed it.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.